Hello ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dan and welcome back to my channel. Today we are finally, after almost a year, continuing our look at Octavarium by Dream Theater. Now I have gathered more familiarity with the song and I've learned it a little bit better, so I think I'm more qualified to teach you how to play it. Now, in the last episode we took a look at the majority of the Someone Like Him section of the song. Today we're gonna finish that section and move over to the next one entitled Medicine Awakening. So, I don't think we should waste any more time, let's get straight into the first part of the song. Now, the first part is the chord progression that goes during the intro of the song. You know where the keyboard plays? Right, and that chord progression is very, very simple and straightforward, and it sounds like this. That is very straightforward, as I said. So what you're gonna do is, for every time the keyboard player starts a new phrase, so we have the intro separated into 8 phrases, you know, with each one being roughly 4 notes like this. That's one phrase. For every time the keyboard player starts a new phrase, the guitarist is gonna play a chord. Now, the first chord is just gonna be a standard F power chord. So our next two chords, you're just gonna play F 3 times. Now the next chord will be a B flat power chord. You may also throw in the octave B flat on the G string if you want to. Now, the next time you go through the chord progression, this is when he moves over one octave. Alright, and during that one you're gonna start off with the F power chord. Then you're gonna move over to a C sharp power chord. D. And then back down to B flat. And then you're gonna hold that chord until you go back into the acoustic section of the song. Alright, now. In the last episode we did not take a look at the chord progression for that part. So we're gonna do just that right now. Now, the chord progression that goes underneath the kind of flute solo at the beginning sounds like this. Pretty cool stuff, a very fun chord progression to play. Now we're gonna start off with an F minor chord for 4 bars. And repeat that 4 times. Then you're gonna move over to a C minor chord. Move it down to a B flat minor. Back to the F minor. Then you're gonna move over to this G chord in the shape of an E. Then this G sharp chord. And then you're gonna move over to this E diminished chord. So, sounds like this. Thank you. Ah, you're gonna move over to this this little F minor chord. You're gonna move your main finger down one fret and hold the bar, or just play the E, my bad, but keep your other three fingers in the same position. Alright, now you're gonna move down to a D and play a D diminished chord. Move it up to an F. And then you're gonna play this chord, which is E in bass, and then you're gonna play the C, this E, and then this extra G over here. Alright, now that's that chord progression. The only final part of Someone Like Him, before we'll move over to Medicine Awakening, is where he starts singing As Far As I Can Tell. And that part sounds like this. This part we're building on the chords that we learned in the previous video, the B flat power chord and then the C sharp power chord, or the A sharp power chord if you will, however. And then you're gonna play a B and the octave of it, and you're gonna play it in the pattern where you play. So you're gonna play the lower version of B, then play the higher version, then you're gonna play the low B three times, and then you're gonna play the high one again. And that's the pattern you're gonna repeat. Except, actually, whenever you restart a pattern, you're gonna play the B one more time. Or two more times, rather, my bad. And then you're gonna, after playing that for a couple times, closing, during the end of that section, you're gonna move it down one fret, and then move it down to the A with the octave. Alright, now this is where the guitarist goes silent and the bass and the drums take over the song. To be someone just for this part, you're gonna wait until the bass obviously cues you in, and then you're gonna play a major chord. You're gonna play the lower notes, and then you're gonna play through the entire chord. So it sounds like this. And then you're gonna play G sharp A on the G string, and then you're gonna hold the F on the D string, the A on the G string, and the G, or sorry, not the G, the D on the B string. And you're gonna play D, G, B, G, E, B, G, or E, E, B, and then you're gonna play the little G sharp A again. Alright. Then you're gonna go back to the A chord. And this time you're gonna play the same to the F and the A, but you're not gonna hold your pinky on the D on the B string, you're gonna keep the B string open. And you're gonna play the exact same thing, except for instead of going G sharp A on the G string, you're gonna just play straight down the chord once you've played the B for the last time. And then instead of going, you're just gonna go. And then you're gonna repeat this entire thing one more time. And then you're gonna keep repeating that until they start singing about a catatonic sleep, right? Because then you're gonna switch over to a F sharp minor chord, but you're gonna play it from the octave of the F sharp, not from the F sharp on the E string. So you're gonna play D, G, B, G, E, B, G, D. Those are the strings you're gonna play in that order. And then you're gonna move down to an F major chord, played from the D string, and do the exact same pattern. And then, once you start singing, for 30 years, where have I been? You're gonna go to this chord. So that's gonna be the 3rd fret on the E and B string, open G, 4th fret on the D string, and 5th fret on the E and A string. Strum it a little bit, and then move down to this, it's an F major chord, but you're gonna keep the E string open. So you gotta play the bass note with your thumb, and then obviously the two lowest notes with your fingers. And then you're gonna move over to an A suspended chord. This is an A major chord, but you're gonna take the pinky off and play the open B string. And you're gonna play that for 2 bars. Then you're gonna repeat the exact same thing. Except this time you're gonna start picking the chord. Doesn't really matter how you pick it, you can just pick it however feels comfortable. And then you're gonna move over to a part where there are 2 guitar parts going on. So the first one plays this. You're gonna play that chord progression. And then you're gonna go back to this. The standard chord progression that we did. Hey guys, future me here. My dumbass forgot to tell you what chords they were. So you're gonna start off with an A major chord, move over to an F major chord starting from the D string, and then an F sharp minor chord starting from the D string. Love ya. The other guitar part, the lead guitar part, the one that Petrucci usually uses when he plays it live is it sounds like this. So, pretty cool stuff there. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna play the vocal melody starting from this E. You're gonna go down to this you're gonna go down to this E C sharp, and then you go to this B and to the A. Then you're gonna go to the E again, play C, B, A. E, C sharp, B, A, B. And then you're gonna go A, B, C, A, B, C, D, E, F, E. And during or in between every single note you play, you're gonna play the open A string as well. Now, the second time you're gonna play, start it off the same way, but instead of going, you're gonna slide down to the F on the E string, play, you're gonna play F, no, sorry, E, and then you're gonna play C, B, A. You're gonna slide up to the F sharp, play the E again, you're gonna play C sharp, B, A. play a D suspended chord. So this is a D chord with the finger of the second fret on the E string removed, finger of the F sharp. And then again, you're gonna go back to the starting chord progression. Now for this part, he cuts off the chord progression after the second time he plays it, so that the drummer gets a little fill in between. What I like to do for this part is I just play this chord, the one that you're supposed to pick through, and then I move it up the octave and play it from the 15th fret, my bad. And then I go back to the chord progression again, the way it's supposed to be. Now, that's that for the second time through. The second time where he goes, you know, that for 30 years, where have I been? He goes to this chord progression, but this is where he starts kicking in the distortion pedal. So he turns it on and he plays the same chord. And then this time he does it a little bit different. He doesn't go back to the same chord, he plays. And then does the exact same thing there. So, the second chord progression is, instead of going back to this chord, he goes. So that's chromatically down from A, G sharp, G, F sharp, F, and then he plays the F major chord. Strums it a couple times, and then goes up to the G major chord. And then does the exact same thing on the melody part. You know, everything the same thing. Now, there's only one more part for this, Medicine Awakening. And that is the chord progression that goes below the keyboard solo. And after that chord progression is done, we're going into Razor's Edge, which is... Full Circle, my bad. Razor's Edge is the final circle. Full Circle is by far the most difficult part of the song and one of the most difficult Dream Theater parts ever written. So, it's probably gonna take me a while to make that video because I don't think I'm good enough to play it yet. Anywho... I think I'll save the chord progression for the next video as well. This one's getting a little bit long. So, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope this guide was helpful. And if it was, please do hit the like button, subscribe. I'd greatly appreciate it. And until next time, peace.